Hello. A few months back, I had shown you how to create dynamic conditional formatting using a checkbox. Today, we'll talk about dynamic charts using checkboxes. Okay? So here we have data of students' names and their marks, the total marks, the average marks, and the grades have been calculated. So let me just copy this data here. So I'll copy the names. I'll press Control from the keyboard and copy the total marks. And finally copy the average marks. Okay. So we'll copy this here. And we'll paste it here on the side here. Okay, so paste. Here we have the data. Now using this data, we'll create a chart. So we go to insert, we'll take the column chart, and there it is. Let me rearrange this a little so that we can see it clearly while we work with it. So there it is. There is our chart. Now the aim is that if I wish to see only the total marks, I should be able to see them, or the average marks, I should be able to see the average marks individually, or both. Okay, so we go to the developer tab. Now we need our checkboxes. So we'll go here to form controls, click on this. So we'll create a form control for the first checkbox and we'll call it total marks. Alright, now we'll create another checkbox for the average marks. So what I want to be able to do now is, if I click on the total marks, I should be able to see only the total marks graph and not the average marks. Similarly for average marks. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to connect this to a cell. So I'll format control, I right clicked on it, format control, I get this window here. When it is checked, I want to link it to one cell, let's say $E, $15, any one cell, okay, that is convenient to access. Similarly for the average marks, I'm going to link it to another cell, let's say to F15. So I use the absolute values. Okay, now as you can see here, let me just show you where that has come. You see this here, true and true, that is the status at the moment, both have been clicked, isn't it? Now I'm going to use a if function. And I want this data to be available only if it is true and not be available if it is false. Okay, so I'll write if $E, $15 is true, then I want my data from E4 to come here, else it should be blank. Okay? Enter. So I'm going to autofill this. So it has been autofill by double clicking. Similarly here, I'm going to say is equal to if $F $15 is true, then should give us the data from F4, else it should be blank. Okay? I'm going to go here and just double click on it and do an autofill. There it is. So now this data here is from E4. So let's see the data in E4. There it is, E4, that is the data, and then autofill. Similarly from F4 and then autofill, isn't it? So now you see this graph, as long as that is true. So if I click here now, your total marks should disappear from the graph. There it is. Now you only see the average marks. If I click here, you get them back. Similarly for the average marks. This is exactly a similar situation as I showed you last year about dynamic conditional formatting. A link is given to that also. I hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching.